I am a sucker for a waltz. I loved the feel of it. I loved how kind of simple and delicate it was, even though and beautiful about something that's so kind of awful.
I enjoy the music in Immaculate Deception. I even really like the lyrics in terms of craft. But as an idea for a song, it disappoints. Here's how Lindsay and Alex felt.
Oh my God, I don't know why Ryan doesn't like Immaculate Deception. I think it's so fun. One of the reasons I really loved it was kind of the first group number that he wrote for us, where all five of us were like the same amount involved. And so I think it was just really fun for us to all have that interaction and moment and be telling like one story together.
At the time, I hated it too. But I will say this, that has easily climbed the charts for me. That's a song that sort of got better to me, at least with age. That's a song that I enjoy more now than I did then.
The title of the song comes from an idea I had for a play in college. It was a farce about the Virgin Mary stuck in her sexless marriage to Joseph. Not to be tied down, Mary, Mother of God, got her little something-something and found herself pregnant, and any of her three neighbors could be the father. No, I was not aware of Mamma Mia yet. Anyway, lest Mary reveal to Joseph she's been unfaithful, she must pretend her baby was immaculately conceived, and of course the three neighbors end up as the three magi, and yeah, you get the picture. I wrote a few scenes for the class, and they weren't very good, and now it's a song in 35mm, and here we are.
In this Waverly gutter, she's giving up tricks, while a shudder is a flutter of clay.
Put plainly, the song is about how the meaning of things can be manipulated into being sellable or commercial, and all you have to do is sell its soul. Clearly, it was a continuation of my critique on religiosity, but I think the idea is kind of lame. Or you might say it's a critique of art, how the mundanity of everyday life can be blown up to gallery size and suddenly it's powerful. But that gets into all kinds of art theory that I, a lowly musical theater composer, have very little understanding about, and I should have just written a song about, I don't know, the Virgin Mary getting around. I honestly don't remember whether the song or the inspiration photograph came first, but I do know that the licensed photograph isn't the one Matthew and I originally signed to the song. The OG was one I still really love. A sky with power lines running horizontally around a group of sunlit clouds, which Matthew titled Notes on a Staff, which meant to me manipulating meaning through the title. I, as a musician, for example, would suddenly be very interested in a photo called Notes on a Staff, whereas if he had called it Waiting to Kill Some Birds, I probably still would have been very interested, but you see my point. Then, in our despair about the song's effectiveness, Matthew changed up the photo to a puddle in an alley, and now that's the photograph, and this is the song, and here we are. But if you really like Immaculate Deception, then I guess the intended, if lame, meaning of the song succeeded, and you too were duped into thinking something was smart when, at least to me, it's not all that profound.
Hallelujah!